Today we will learn exercise 13.2 of chapter 13 surface areas and volumes. In previous class we learned the formula for finding surface areas and for volumes of solid figures. Surface area and volume of cuboid, cube, cylinder, cone, then sphere, hemisphere, etc. We already learned. In second exercise, almost all the questions are related to cylinder. So, lateral surface area or CSA, curved surface area of cylinder, that is 2 pi RH. So, this is cylinder, right circular cylinder, and the radius of the cylinder, height of the cylinder, and the curved surface area of cylinder, 2 pi RH. We already learned that formula, 2 pi RH. And the total surface area of cylinder, that is curved surface area plus area of base plus area of top, that is 2 pi RH plus 2 pi RH, curved surface area plus area of base, that is a circle, and area of top, that is another circle. So 2 pi RH plus 2 pi R square. So when we take 2 pi R outside, H plus R. So this is the formula for finding total surface area of cylinder. And the curved surface area formula 2 pi RH. So by using these two formula we can do exercise 13.2. So we will do the sums one by one. Question number 1. Here the curved surface area of right circular cylinder. Curved surface area of right circular cylinder of height. Of height 14 cm. Height is given and the curved surface area is given 88 cm square. Curved surface area of a right circular cylinder of height 14 cm is 88 cm square. Find the diameter of the base of the cylinder. So by using the given condition we need to find the diameter of the base. So curved surface area formula 2 pi RH is equal to 88 cm square, that is 2 into 22 by 7 into radius is not given, radius we have to find, height is given 14 equal to 88, therefore radius 88. Now we can take these terms from left to right, 2 will become 1 by 2 when we take from left to right. 22 by 7 will be 7 by 22 into 14 will be 1 by 14. So when we simplify, we will get a radius of the cylinder, then diameter. So we can easily find a diameter is 2 into radius. So when we multiply this radius by 2, we will get a diameter of that cylinder. So that is question number 1. Then second question. In second question, we need to find the second one. It is required to make a closed cylindrical tank. A closed cylindrical tank of height 1 meter. Height is equal to 1 meter. And the base diameter 140 centimeter. Base diameter 140 centimeter. So base radius is 140 divided by 2. That is 70 centimeter. And we need to make a closed cylindrical tank from a metal sheet. How many square meters of the sheet are required for the same? So here we are going to make a closed cylindrical tank by using a metal sheet. So we need to make all the surfaces, curved surface, base and top by using metal sheet. So we need to find the area of the metal sheet used. Area of metal sheet used and the total surface area will be same. So when we find the total surface area here, radius in 70 centimeter and height in 1 meter. So the units are different. And how many square meters of the sheet? So we can convert 70 centimeter into meter. So when we convert centimeter into meter, we have to divide it by 100. 70 upon 100 meter, that is 7 by 10 meter. So that is radius. Now area of metal sheet, area of metal sheet, area of metal sheet is equal to TSA of cylinder. Because it is a closed cylinder, TSA of cylinder, and the formula 2 pi r into r plus h. And we will replace 2 into 22 by 7 into radius 7 by 10 and in bracket r plus h, that is 7 by 10 plus height 1. So when we simplify, we will get area of metal sheet. So that is second question. Now we will do third one. Question number 3. And here a metal pipe is 77 cm long. The inner diameter of cross section is 4 cm and the outer diameter is 4.4 cm. Find its inner curved surface area, outer curved surface area, total surface area. So that is our question. A metal pipe 77 cm long. Third question, it is a metal pipe 77 cm long. So this is metal pipe. And its length, that means a metal pipe is in the shape of a cylinder. And its length is 77 cm long. So 77 cm long, that is length. That means the height of the cylinder. And the inner diameter 4 cm. Therefore, inner radius 2 cm. Inner radius 2 cm. And the outer diameter 4.4 cm. Therefore, the outer radius 2.2 cm. So, we will write inner radius. We can take it as smaller triangle R. Inner radius R is equal to 4 by 2. That is equal to 2 cm. Then outer radius. Outer radius we can take as capital letter R, that is outer diameter divided by 2, that is 2.2 cm. Inner radius is inner diameter divided by 2, 4 by 2, 2 cm. Outer radius, outer diameter divided by 2, 4.4 divided by 2, 2.2 cm. Height. Height will be same. Inner height and outer height will be same. So height h is equal to 77 cm. So these are the given values. Then we need to find the inner curved surface area, outer curved surface area, total surface area. So that is our question. So first part, inner curved surface area. Inner CSA we will find. Then we have to find the outer curved surface area. Then we need to find the total surface area. So here, this is a pipe. So the pipe, so inner radius and outer radius both are different. So see, this is a, suppose it is a pipe, then this is the height and here some thickness is there, that's why inner radius and outer radius both are different. That means some thickness is there and that thickness is 0.2 cm thickness and inner radius, then inner radius, then outer radius, then height. And when we find inner curved surface area, so here inside we have a curved surface, so we need to find the inner curved surface area. The height will be same, inner height and outer height same. And when we find inner curved surface area, formula 2 pi rh, inner curved surface area, that is 2 pi rh. And here small letter r we will use because that is inner radius. Then we will replace 2 into 22 by 7 into radius, inner radius, 2 into height 77 cm. So when we simplify, we will get an inner curved surface area. Then second part, we need to find the outer curved surface area. Outer curved surface area is outer curved surface. So this is outer curved surface. So when we find outer curved surface area, that is 2 pi rh, and here we will take outer radius. So the formula will be 2 pi capital RH, 2 pi capital RH, and 2 into 22 by 7 into radius capital R, that is 2.2, 2.2 we can write 22 by 10, 2 pi RH, height 77, so when we simplify we will get outer curved surface area. Then the third part, we need to find the total surface area. So that is the third part. Third part is total surface area. So total surface area is, so this is our pipe. We need to find a total surface area. And when we find the total surface area of a pipe, so here we have curved surface, outer curved surface, then inner curved surface, and here area of this part, area of this part, and here also area of that part. So the total surface area is outer curved surface area plus inner curved surface area plus this is called ring, area of ring. And here both the faces are identical. So area of this ring plus area of this one. So when we find area of this ring, this part. So here we have outer circle and we have inner circle. So this is the region between outer circle and inner circle. So this is the region. So area of that region is equal to area of outer circle minus area of inner circle. Area of outer circle minus area of inner circle, that is area of that region. So area of outer circle, that is pi capital R square, pi R square, minus area of inner circle, that is pi small r square. So that will be the area of that region, this white portion. So because here we have 0.2 centimeter thickness, so when we find total surface area of this pipe, outer covered surface area plus inner covered surface area plus area of this portion. So that is pi capital R square minus pi small r square, and the same here also. So we can multiply by 2. So when we find total surface area, we can write inner CSA plus outer CSA plus 2 into area of ring. 2 into area of ring. So inner CSA is 2 pi RH plus outer CSA, that is 2 pi capital RH plus area of ring, that is outer curved surface, area of ring, that means area of this part. Area of this part is equal to pi R square minus pi R square, and here also both the faces are identical, so we will multiply by 2. So 2 into in bracket pi capital R square minus pi small r square. So pi capital R square, that is area of outer circle, minus pi small r square, that is area of inner circle. So that will be area of this part into 2. That means this also covered. So this is the total surface area of the pipe. And 2 pi RH we will get from here. And 2 pi capital RH we will get from here. And when we replace here, pi into, or we can write 2 pi RH plus 2 pi capital RH plus, we can take it 2 pi outside, then R square minus R square. A square minus B square is A plus B to A minus B. Therefore, R square minus R square is R plus R into R minus R. So both of them are same. 2 pi into R plus R into R minus R, that is 2 pi into R square minus R square, that is 2 into pi R square minus pi R square. So when we simplify, when we replace capital R by 2.2, small r by 2, then pi by 22/7, and 2 pi RH and 2 pi RH from part 1 and part 2, when we replace, we will get a total surface area of that pipe, we will get. So that is question number 3. Now we will do fourth one. In fourth question is the diameter of a roller is 84 centimeter and its length is 120 centimeter. Diameter of a roller is 84 centimeter and its length is 120 centimeter. Then it takes 500 complete revolutions. So we can write the given condition. Fourth question we are doing. Diameter 84 centimeter, so radius is equal to 84 divided by 2, that is 42 centimeter. and length, that means height, height is equal to 120 centimeter. Then it takes 500 complete revolutions to move once over to level a playground. Find the area of the playground in meter square. So that is our question. It takes 500 revolutions to complete one round. Suppose this is the roller. The shape of the roller is a cylinder. Suppose this is a roller. And here height is given 120 centimeter and the radius of this roller is 42 centimeter. Height 120 centimeter, radius 42 centimeter, and it takes 500 revolutions to level the playground. And suppose this board is the playground. This board is the playground. And we are going to, if you want to level this playground, it takes 500 revolutions. If it takes 500 revolutions to level the playground, find the area of the playground. That is our question. So, suppose this is roller and this is the playground. And we want to level this playground. And when we level this playground, total 500 revolutions required. So, if we need 500 revolutions, then what would be the area of the playground? That is our question. Suppose we are starting from here. And this is the roller. And if you start from here, you will keep here. And you see here one joining, one line is there. So you just note down here. And when we start from here, that line here. And here, see, one revolution not completed. So you see that line again here. So now we can say one complete revolution. One revolution completed. So once again you see, we are starting from here. This is the line. And we are leveling the playground. And see, now we can say we completed one revolution. So when we complete one revolution, just hear that point. And see, here, this area is in one revolution, this roller will cover this area. In one revolution, this roller will cover this area. And that area is actually, see, we are starting from here. This area is actually the curved surface area of roller. So, curved surface area of this roller and area covered by the roller in one revolution. It is same, equal. So, area covered by roller in one revolution and curved surface area of roller, equal, same. So here 500 revolutions are there. By it takes 500 complete revolutions to move once over to level the ground. So that is the question. So if you want to find area of playground is equal to, so in one revolution, area covered in one revolution is equal to CSA of cylinder. So, area covered in 500 revolution is equal to 500 into CSA of cylinder. So, area of playground is equal to area covered in 500 complete revolutions. Area covered in 500 complete revolutions. Area covered in 500 complete revolutions, that is area of playground. So, it's given condition. And area covered in 500 complete revolutions, that is 500 into CSA of cylinder or roller. 500 into CSA of cylinder or roller. That is 500 into CSA of roller or CSA of cylinder. That is 2 pi RH. That is 500 into, then 2 into 22 by 7 into radius. 42 into height 120. So when we simplify, we will get a area of playground. And that area of playground is equal to 500 into area covered in one revolution. Area covered in 500 complete revolution, that is 500 into area covered in one revolution. Area covered in one revolution is curved surface area of cylinder. So area covered in 500 revolution is equal to 500 into curved surface area of cylinder. That is 500 into 2 pi RH. Then when we replace, we will get an answer. So that is fourth question. question number 5. So here in 5th question, a cylindrical pillar is 50 cm in diameter. Question number 5. A cylindrical pillar is 50 cm in diameter and 3.5 meter in height. So radius, that is 50 cm in diameter, that is 50 upon 2, that is 25 cm, and height 3.5 meter, units are different. Find the cost of painting the curved surface of the pillar at the rate of rupees 12.5 per meter square. So this centimeter we can convert into meter. So 25 centimeter, that is 25 upon 100 meter, and 3.5 meter, that is 35 by 10 meter. We can avoid decimals. Then we need to find the cost of painting the curved surface of the pillar at the rate of rupees 12.5 per meter square. So cost of painting, we need to find, before that we need to find the CSA, curved surface area. Curved surface area of the pillar. The pillar is in the shape of a cylinder, so the curved surface area is 2 pi r h. So that is 2 into 22 by 7 into radius 25 by 100 into height 35 upon 10. So 2 pi r h, curved surface area. Now cost of painting. Cost of painting is equal to curved surface area into curved surface area into cost per meter square, that is 12.5. So when we simplify, here we will get a curved surface area, then curved surface area into 12.5. And here in this question, no need to simplify this answer. So directly we will write 2 into 22 by 7 into 25 by 100 into 35 by 10 into 12.5, that is 125 upon 10. Now we can cancel the terms, then we will get the final answer. So cancellation we will do in the final step, that is easy. So we will get a cost of painting, that is question number 5. Now we will do 6th one. In question number 6, curved surface area of right circular cylinder is 4.4 meter square. Curved surface area of right circular cylinder is 4.4 meter square, and the radius of the base 0.7 meter. Find height. Direct question. Radius is given. Radius is equal to 0.7 meter, and curved surface area. Curved surface area is equal to 4.4 meter square. Find the height. That is our question. So curved surface area, formula 2 pi r h is equal to 4.4. 4.4 is 44 upon 10, and 7 meter, 0.7 is 7 by 10 meter, and curved surface area, that is given 44 upon 10, and we will replace the values 2 into 22 by 7 into radius, 7 by 10 into height is equal to 44 upon 10. Therefore, height is equal to 44 divided by 10 into, take the reciprocals, 2 becomes 1 by 2, then 22 by 7 becomes 7 by 22, 7 by 10 becomes 10 by 7. So when we simplify, we will get a height of that cylinder. That is, now we will do 7th question. Question number 7. The inner diameter of a circular well, 3.5 meter, and it is 10 meter deep. Inner diameter is given, and depth, height, the circular well, the shape of a well is a cylinder, and its diameter is given, so we can find a radius. 7th question, radius is equal to, diameter is given 3.5 meter. So the radius is 3.5 divided by 2. Meter, that is 35 upon 20 meter radius, and its height, the depth, that well is in the shape of a cylinder, so its height is 10 meter. So 10 meter. find its inner curved surface area. First part, we need to find the inner CSA. Formula 2 pi RH. So 2 into 22 by 7 into radius 35 upon 20 into height 10. So when we simplify, we will get inner CSA. Then second part, the cost of plastering this curved surface at the rate of rupees 40 per meter square. So cost of plastering. So we need to find the cost of plastering. So the cost of plastering is, we need to find the cost of plastering the inner curved surface. So cost of plastering is equal to inner CSA, inner curved surface area, into cost per meter square. So the cost per meter square is rupees 40 per meter square into 40. So when we simplify here, we will get the inner covered surface area. And here we have two parts, so we need to simplify here. So that is inner covered surface area. Then cost of plastering, that is inner covered surface area, into rupees 40 per meter square. So when we multiply inner covered surface area by 40, we will get a cost of plastering. So that is second part. Then question number 8. In 8th question, so here in a hot water heating system, there is a cylindrical pipe of length 28 meter. In a hot water heating system, there is a cylindrical pipe of length 28 meter and diameter 5 centimeter. So length, that means height 28 meter and diameter 5 centimeter. So radius is equal to 5 upon 2 centimeter. Units are different. And diameter 5 centimeter. Find the total radiating surface in the system. So we need to find the total radiating surface. So 5 by 2 centimeter. Radiating surface 5 by 2, we will write centimeter, we can convert into meter. So 5 by 2 centimeter, that is equal to 2.5 centimeter. So that is 2.5 divided by 100 meter, that is 25 upon 1000 meter. So this is the radius 5 by 2, 2.5, that in meter, 2.5 upon 100 meter. So when we multiply by 10 by 10, 25 upon 1000 meter, that is radius, and height 28 meter. Then we need to find the total radiating surface. So that is a cylinder, and here the height of the cylinder is given and the radius also given, and that cylinder may be attached here, this side, and here also it may be attached here. Then we need to find the total radiating surface. So total radiating surface is actually curved surface. Curved surface. So, find the total radiating surface. Area of radiating surface is equal to curved surface area. So we will write area of radiating surface. Radiating surface is equal to CSA of cylinder. CSA of cylinder, that is 2 pi r h, and now we can replace 2 into 22 by 7 into 2 into 22 by 7 into r, 25 upon 1000 into height 28. So when we simplify, we will get a total radiating surface. Now question number 9 we can do, and here in 9th question, find the lateral curved surface area of a closed cylindrical petrol storage tank. We have two parts here in question number 9. Find the lateral or curved surface area of a closed cylindrical petrol storage tank that is 4.2 meter in diameter. So radius is equal to 4.2 divided by 2, that is 4.2 divided by 2 meter, that is 2.1 meter. The total curved surface area, or the lateral or curved surface area of a closed cylindrical petrol storage, that is 4.2 meter in diameter and height 4.5 meter height. h is equal to 4.5 meter height. So 2.1 meter, that is 21 upon 10 meter, and 4.5 meter height, that is 45 upon 10 meter height, and radius 21 by 10 meter. Then we need to find a lateral surface area or curved surface area. That is the first part, CSA. So here first part we will write here. First part, CSA is equal to formula. It is a cylindrical tank, closed cylindrical tank, but we need to find only curved surface area here in first part, that is 2 pi rh. That is 2 into 22 by 7 into radius 21 by 10, 2 pi r h, height 45 upon 10. So when we simplify, we will get a curved surface area. That is first part. Then second part. In second part, how much steel was actually used? How much steel was actually used? If 1 by 12 of the steel actually used was wasted in making the tank. So we need to find how much steel actually used. Suppose it is a cylindrical tank. It is given. It is a cylindrical tank. And by using steel, if you make a cylindrical tank, first we have to calculate the total surface area. This is closed cylindrical tank. And suppose you are going to make a closed cylindrical tank. And when you make a closed cylindrical tank, first you should have clear idea about the size of the tank. So radius and height, then we will find the total surface area of the, first we will calculate the total surface area of the tank. Then we need to purchase material for how much steel, we need to purchase for making this tank. So for that, first we have to calculate the total surface area. And when we purchase steel for making this tank, we need to purchase something, some extra. So suppose you are calculating the total surface area, and if you purchase only that much steel equal to total surface area, then here we may have some cutting, joining, etc. will be there. So we need to buy some extra. So that is given here. How much steel was actually used? If 1 by 12 of the steel actually used was wasted in making the tank. So when we make the tank by cutting, overlapping, etc. 1 by 12 of the steel actually used wasted. So that means we are purchasing something extra. And when we purchase something extra, it's 1 by 12 wasted. So area of, we need to find how much steel was actually used. So we can do like this. Let the area of steel actually used. Area of steel actually used be x meter square. Let the area of steel actually used be x meter square. That means that much steel we purchased from the shop. And area of steel actually used, that means area of steel purchased for making the tank, that is x meter square. And that area is always greater than area of the tank. Area of the total surface area of tank is always less than the total surface area of steel we purchased from the shop. Because here we are wasting, cutting, overlapping, etc. So we purchased something extra. Therefore, this area of steel actually used, that is x meter square, that is always greater than total surface area of the cylinder. So this is area of steel actually used, x meter square. Then area of steel wasted, that is given 1 by 12 of the area of steel actually used, wasted, that is given in the question. So 1 by 12 x. So area of steel wasted equal to 1 by 12 x. 1 by 12, that is given in the question. How much steel was actually used? If 1 by 12 of the steel actually used was wasted. So area of steel actually used x meter square. So area of steel wasted, that is 1 by 12. 1/12 is. Then, therefore, area of steel used. Area of steel used. Area of steel wasted 1/12. Area of steel wasted 1/12. So area of steel used, that is equal to total we purchased x, and 1/12 x wasted, 1/12 x wasted. So area of steel actually used is 11/12 x. Steel actually used, and the rest of the steel wasted, overlapping, cutting, etc. ratio. So area of steel used and TSI of cylinder will be same. So we will write now. Area of steel used. Area of steel used. Area of steel used and TSI of cylinder, both are same. Because we purchased something extra and we wasted 1/12 x and we used 11/12 x, we used for making the tank, and the rest of the wasted means overlapping, cutting, etc. So the steel used and the TSI of cylinder will be same. So the area of steel used, that is 11/12 x, is equal to TSI of cylinder, that is 2 pi r into r plus h. So that is 2 into 22/7. Then radius, radius is 21/10. Then r plus h, that is 21/10 plus height, 45/10. And when we simplify, we will get one number here. Right side we will get one number. That is 11/12 x is equal to that number. Therefore, x is equal to 11/12, we can take from left to right. So, 12/11 into this one. Area of steel, TSI of cylinder. So, when we simplify here, 2 pi r into r plus h. So, when we replace these old values and when we simplify, we will get a TSI of cylinder. And we can take 11/12 from left to right. Therefore, x is equal to 12/11 into TSI of cylinder. 12/11 into TSI of cylinder. So, that is area of steel actually used. So, after that, we will write, therefore, area of steel actually used equal to x meter square. That is equal to, from here, we will get that value when we simplify. That is area of steel actually used. So that is question number 9. Now we will do 10th question. In question number 10, so here in figure, one figure is given. You see the frame of a lampshade. You see the frame of a lampshade. It is to be covered with a decorative cloth. The frame has a base diameter 20 cm. So see, here we have a lampshade. Cylindrical shape. Lampshade, cylindrical shape. The frame has a base diameter 20 cm. So, radius. Radius is equal to 20 upon 2. That is equal to 10 cm. Radius 10 cm. And height 30 cm. Height 30 cm. Height h is equal to 30 cm. A margin of 2.5 cm is to be given for folding it over the top and the bottom of the frame. Find how much cloth is required for covering the lampshade. So here the shape of a lampshade is cylinder and the height is 30 cm and the radius 10 cm. And we are going to cover that lampshade by using a cloth, and it's given a margin of 2.5 cm extra needed here to cover the side, and here also 2.5 extra needed to cover the base. Then what would be the area of cloth used? That is our question. And see, suppose this is the lampshade, cylindrical shape, and the height of the lampshade 30 cm, and the radius of the lampshade 10 cm. And by using this cloth, we are going to cover this lampshade. And here you see, here we have base and here we have top. So when we use this cloth to cover this lampshade, so we need to cover the base and the top. So if you want to cover the base and the top, so we need a 2.5 extra here, a margin of 2.5 extra, and here also 2.5 extra, that is given in the question. A margin of 2.5 cm is to be given for folding it over the top and the bottom of the frame. Find how much cloth is required for covering the lampshade. So, height 30 cm. And we need something extra here. That is 2.5. And here also 2.5. Now we can cover the lampshade. Using this cloth, we can cover the lampshade. Completely we cover it. And here, 2.5 extra here for covering this top. And similarly, for covering the bottom, 2.5 extra. So we can cover the lampshade completely. And we need to find what is the total area of the sheet used. Total area of the sheet used to cover the lampshade. So that is our question. And here, total area of the sheet used. You see, here when we cover the lampshade, and here some overlapping is there. And here some overlapping, some folding, overlapping is there. So total area of the cloth used will not be equal to total surface area of the cylinder. Because here when we fold this, when we fold this cloth, so here you see some overlapping is there. So when we find the total surface area of the cylinder, total surface area of this lampshade and total area of this cloth, both are different. So total area of the cloth is always greater than the total surface area of the lampshade because some overlapping is there. So if you want to find the area of cloth, so we can easily find that. So you see, so this is the cloth, and here up to here 30 cm, then 2.5 extra, 2.5 extra. So the height, now the height of the height is equal to 30 plus 2.5 plus 2.5, that is 30 plus that is actual height. Therefore actual height is equal to, or height of the covering sheet, actual height, that is height of the covering sheet, height of sheet. So because this covering sheet form a cylinder, so actual height, we can take actual height is equal to 35 plus, so this is 35, up to here this is 35, plus 2.5 plus 2.5, that is 35 cm, that is actual height. And radius same only, radius same. So this covering sheet itself a cylinder, so area of covering sheet is equal to curved surface area of this one. So curved surface area, so the curved surface area, area of covering sheet, covering cloth, area of covering cloth equal to area of cloth is equal to CSA. Area of cloth is equal to CSA. So CSA, and when we find CSA, the height will be 35 cm, it will not be 30 cm, and the radius will be same 10 cm. So CSA formula 2πRH. CSA 2πRH, that is 2 into 22 by 7 into radius 10 into height 35. So when we simplify, we will get a area of cloth used, and the area of cloth used and the total surface area of cylinder both are different. Reason, here some overlapping is there. So if you calculate total surface area of cylinder for finding area of cloth, then that will be wrong. So area of cloth is equal to CSA, curved surface area, and that is not the curved surface area of the cylinder, that is curved surface area of the cylinder formed by that cloth. So that is CSA of the cylinder formed by that cloth, that is 2πRH. So that is question number 10th question. Then we have one more question. That is the last one. Then 11th question. The students of a Vidyalaya were asked to participate in a competition for making and decorating pen holders in the shape of a cylinder with a base using cardboard. Pen holder in the shape of a cylinder, and we are making that pen holder with a cardboard pen holder. Pen holder, that means the top will be opened. Each pen holder was to be of radius 3 cm. 11th question, radius 3 cm. And the height, h is equal to 10.5 cm. The Vidyalaya was to supply the competitors with cardboard. If there were 35 competitors, how much cardboard was required to be bought for the competition? So here, 35 students are there, and each student make a pen holder. So when we make a pen holder, so pen holder, that is a cylinder, but here it is opened. This side is opened now. So the cardboard used to make the pen holder, that is curved surface plus area of base. So that is area of cardboard used for making a pen holder. So that is curved surface area plus area of base. So here we have 35 students. So 35 pen holder. So area of cardboard used. Area of cardboard used is equal to total 35 students are there. 35 into area of cardboard used for one pen holder. That is 35 into area of cardboard used for one pen holder. So we can write a total area. Total area of cardboard used is equal to 35 into area of cardboard used for one pen holder. So that is 35 into area of cardboard used for one pen holder. That is curved surface area plus area of base. Curved surface area, that is 2 pi rh, plus area of base, that is pi r square. Now we can simplify. We will replace 35 into. Now we can replace 2 into 22 by 7 into radius 3 into height 10.5, we can write 105 upon 10 plus pi, that is 22 by 7 into r square, radius 3 into 3. And here 22 by 7 we can take outside, then that 7 and 35 will be cancelled. Then when we simplify, we will get a area of cardboard, total area of cardboard used. Total area of cardboard used is equal to 35 into area of cardboard used for one pen holder. Area of cardboard used for one pen holder is curved surface area plus area of base. So into 35, so we will get the answer.